Again, I'm a voyeur, so I love it. I'll watch it.
Sideshow shows come in and stuff. Do you still do those?
Oh, yeah.
Like this? Oh, yeah. The butterflies, you know, before you get on, you know, you're waiting in line.
Certified free, 7 days a week.
Yo, what up, body shoppers? Jell Smino here with
Marilu.
And
Anne.
And
Zoey Violet.
Oh, yay, the gang's all here. And Jason right out of the box.
Yep.
What's up, Jason? So I have some disappointing news for everybody.
What?
The kilt that I was going to wear on Saturday no longer fits me.
It just needs to be taken in.
Mm. Well,
throw a few more pleats in it and you're fine.
Yeah, maybe. It's a little disappointing. I was actually going to wear it tonight and then show it off on the live stream so people could see it. But, you know, what's up, Big Bacchus?
Hello, hello.
Hey.
Jason apparently is already on the hard do alcohol.
So. Did you say hard do or hard poo?
Oh, giving Jason their first drink of the night.
Wow, yeah. Marilu coming out of the box, firing poo.
Gifting it.
Marilu coming out with a poo shooter.
Already starting.
Or shooting shots. Shooting poo. Okay. What were we? Wait a minute. I feel like we watched something in the last week that there was some weird poop thing, like poop.
I told you the story about playing different poop games with my daughter on Roblox. There was like poop mini golf and exploding poops, and yeah, it was quite the experience. She had a great time. I'll show you later.
So it sounds like you two had a fun time playing poo games.
Yes, we did.
Our viewers are already blackout drunk. Our viewers are already blackout drunk with the amount of times we just said poo. They just had to take like
Pace it
20 shots.
What's up, Brian? Yeah, so I think we should just start calling this the poo cast.
Well,
stop.
I was just kind of like.
He's always like, stop.
There's a game for
this? There's several of them first, Roblox, yeah.
When you first started saying it, I was like, were you actually physically flinging poo? And then I realized that you were talking about a game, and kids will be kids, and they'll do some nasty things. I just wanted to clarify.
She's in that bathroom humor stage at the moment, where you know farts and poo are very funny.
They're always going to be funny.
Well, I mean, they're not my
never
favorite.
Go out of style. Never go out of style.
I'm hoping it's a phase.
Well, I mean, look at G. I mean, it's not a phase with him at 50.
I'm not playing poo games. I mean, I'm not like playing shits and ladders.
God, shits and ladders. I can't.
I'm like, what?
So, I'm just going to say this now.
Yes.
I have a, if you're interested, if anybody's interested, and we're going to leave this sort of to the general audience for all four people that are watching right now. I have a very personal poo story to tell.
Hold on.
But it could, we could save it for later. We don't have to talk about it now. We could save it for another time altogether. I'm just saying we came right out of the box with a bunch of poo. So, you know,
is it something that's going to like intoxicate our viewers because of so much?
No, actually, it was just kind of an interesting story.
Okay.
Anyway, we can move on. Anyway,
spill the tea.
Yes, yeah, so Big B says go for it.
I'll give you my little wrong.
Hold on. First of all,
let's have a Kiki. Come on now.
First of
go
all,
go for it.
Hello, Stephanie.
Hi, Stephanie. Yes, we're just getting started here. We're only 5 minutes in. We. Oh my gosh, Bonnie. Jeez.
Bonnie says poo, poo, poo.
I mean, it's really, really personal, and you know, I'm just saying. Anyway, I'm Joel Cimino. I am the owner of the Body Shop. Also of Save
what a way to pivot.
Hard pivot.
Stayed left with that one.
This way diagonally is my beautiful wife, Mary Lou, who is also the co-owner of the Body Shop in Pittsburgh and SaverSex.com and the owner of MaryLouAndYou.com. She is a board certified sexologist and amazing in bed. Hold on. Which way?
Oh.
Nope. Wrong way. This is actually my left, but you're right, correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. My left, you're right. That's Zoey Violet. Zoey Violet is one of our newest additions to the Body Shop office staff, full-time staff. You'll be seeing a lot more of them probably on social media and answering your emails and phone calls and all kinds of weird and crazy stuff.
Go like our TikTok so G doesn't fire me.
Yes. Thanks. Yes. Wait, how many followers do we need before we can do whatever we need to do?
1,000.
All right, we need 1,000 followers. Well, we need 1,000 followers by the end of this cast.
Yeah, and I need 1,000 followers on mine so I can do my thing too.
Yes, go follow us everywhere. Social media.
And in that vein, the person directly above me is Anne, who is the person and puppeteer of the entire Body Shop operation. I don't know if that was puppeteer or Frankenstein. That was
change it. Hold on.
Yeah.
You're supposed to raise your arm. Wrong arm.
Wrong arm.
What is that guy's name in Pinocchio? What's his name?
Pinocchio.
In Pinocchio?
No, the
Geppetto. Yeah. I'm definitely not Geppetto. Oh, Jason wants to know if we have an Instagram.
Yes.
Yes, we do.
We have it all.
Yeah. Is our Instagram at Body Shop Clubs or is it Club Body Shop?
Body Shop Clubs.
Yep.
Okay. I don't even know anymore. I don't know what our social medias are anymore. I guess I don't need to necessarily.
I lied. It's Club Body Shop. You're correct. But our TikTok is Body Shop Clubs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe.
Yes.
Maybe we'll change that too. Maybe we should make them all the same.
That would, you know, consistency would make sense.
Consistency is key.
Sometimes you can and sometimes you can't.
Right.
Yeah.
I like how Mary Lou changes it. Follow me.
Especially after the Sam Smith song. I don't know if we're ever going to get that title. Like, we can never abandon any of our usernames.
Maybe we could put up some links for the Mary Lou and You and the TikTok for Body Shop, the Instagram.
Well, actually, all of you can do that.
Yeah,
I can do it.
Yeah, where's our person to put up our links?
Gotcha. I'm sorry if y'all hear me clacking on my loud keyboard.
We do need to get Zoey a new keyboard.
Did you say prolapsing?
Clacking.
Oh. How do you prolapse on your keyboard? Like,
is that part of your story?
What?
Is that part of your story?
No, God, no. No. No, but equally weird.
Oh. Okay, we'll leave that at that.
We need to get, 5 more people on here to be Brady Bunch?
I think so.
I think I want to get 5 more on here just to see what it actually looks like.
Oh, you mean like actually have the whole thing?
Ken went back from a long hiatus.
Hello.
Hello, Ken.
Cool.
Oh, hi, Stephanie. I think we missed Stephanie. Did we miss him?
No. We said hi,
Stephanie.
Yeah. Sorry. There must be something going on tonight. Is there like a Penguins game or something tonight? Anyone know?
I'm not sure.
Yeah. Anyone follow that?
don't know. I'm not a sports person. I'm gay.
Yeah. Did you say I'm not a sports person? I'm gay?
Yeah.
I don't think the two go hand in hand necessarily, but I agree.
There's some overlay, though.
That I am
completely apart.
I am also not really a sports person. You know, go sports, yay.
Go sports, yay.
Yeah, go sports, people. Yay.
Home team, go.
What is up, Amy?
Oh, my God.
So.
There you go.
Look at that.
What do we have going on this weekend?
This past weekend
was DVNC, which is a reiteration of our Freaky Friday event.
Mm-hmm.
And that was great.
Cool.
Was it really, though?
I thought it was. Yeah, there was.
No, it was good.
So there was so much rope tying going on the dance floor at some portion of the night. I had to move a piece of equipment that we had brought out to make space in the dungeon.
Mm-hmm.
So that the rope people could have more space in the dungeon. Equipment piece could get used. So I would call that a success.
There you go.
There was a lot of people getting their kink on. We had fire play and they did tying on the bamboo pole. They did like regular tying in a ring. There was all kinds of cool stuff.
Cool.
There was homemade s'mores.
There was
homemade s'mores, yeah.
Oh, there was Jiffy Pop. All of this on Friday.
There was Jiffy Pop as well.
There was
Jiffy Pop.
There was Jiffy Pop.
I thought I was having a stroke. I'm not going to lie.
We had to investigate, and we found the fireplace people had made some Jiffy Pop.
Yeah.
I totally missed all of that.
Yeah.
Shout out to Valfria.
Hello, Corey.
And, yay. So Amy pulled pretty much what everybody else has done at least once, which is start watching last week's live stream like it's this week's. You're not alone, Amy. Stephanie says butterboard equals amazing. I have to agree.
Aren't they so tasty? Oh my gosh.
Fuck. If you've not had a butterboard in your life, you are not fucking living.
Yeah.
A butterboard? A butterboard.
Yeah.
Queso got tied to the cross for the first time on Freaky Friday.
Oh. Okay, I saw that. I was talking to Queso while she was getting tied to the cross.
So I need clarification on that. Does that mean the first time at our club on one of our crosses or the first time ever getting tied to a cross?
I think they're normally on the other side of the cross, like on the flogger end of it. So I want to say it was their first time on a cross, but let's see if they clarify for us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Valfreya says that they'll be coming next Friday for their first time, and they look forward to it. Probably really packed because it's St. Patty's Day, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
I would highly recommend. Highly.
Now, are they saying this weekend? Yeah.
Frey, would you like could clarify? Are you meaning this upcoming Friday or the one after?
Yeah.
Queso clarified it was their first time on a cross ever. Normally they do floor tie or suspension.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
So to clarify for our audience listening, they got tied with a rope to the cross. Like tied. Rope tied.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I was talking to them while this was getting done. I think it was, pink rope, if I remember correctly?
Mm.
Who did the tying?
John. So,
Valfreya is going to be coming to our next Freaky Friday. And that, it should be a really good event, Valfreya. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm going to let you finish up about the weekend.
What's that?
I'm going to let you finish up about the weekend, but I do have a quick announcement to make right after.
Sure. So Saturday was our members' appreciation event. Which, if you are not familiar with those, for everybody who attends the event, we give you 3 months of bronze membership on us for coming to the event, just as our way of saying thank you. So, we gave out a lot of memberships.
Fuck.
We were busy. It was great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just want to comment on that really quick. So there were well over 200 people at Saturday's event. well over. And I will say that 2 years ago, maybe even a year ago, I'll stretch it. 200, 250 people would have been a really tough night for us. Meaning it just would have seemed so much busier, more chaotic, whatever. Yeah. This time around, it was just everything ran so smoothly. And the communication was amazing. And just everybody worked really well together. So, and the reason I say that is I just want to give a shout out to the staff for really just doing a tremendous job running these events. I had a meeting this week with somebody that we've been working with for well over a year now, just to help build the business and business ideas and stuff like that. And I kind of complained a little bit that I said, I really felt like I wasn't needed. And so they said, wait a minute, hold on a second. And they asked me a question. They said, do you remember what you said you wanted when we started this? And I'll repeat, not verbatim, but I'll give you a paraphrase it. I said, I really want the autonomy to be able to not have to work or not be here or not be relevant to the club operation. So that if I wanted to travel or go do something, meaning me and Marilu, whatever, we could do that. So they read that back to me and I kind of laughed. I said, yeah, I mean, we're pretty much at that point. I have Anne to thank for that, and Zoey and Sherilyn behind Zoey and all the other staff that have helped, you know, create such a wonderful environment for the members. So
thank you. Yeah, we have a really good crew.
Geez, angels.
Yes. Actually, we talked about this. We said,
I'm trying to go on the other side.
We have to do a Charlie's Angels thing. I'm Bosley, Joe is Charlie.
And why would that be?
Because Joe is rarely seen, and I'm seen every week.
True. True. I'll give you that. Around, he's just really good at being stealthy.
Yeah. And it's not even like you can blame the height either, because Joe is relatively a tall person as well.
I have a tendency to sneak up on people here at the club during the week. If I don't keep my keys like on me so they jingle, I tend to be relatively quiet.
Yeah.
And have scared me quite a few times with her light feet.
Valfria is asking if we have their names on file, they should bring a copy of the receipt.
So when you come to check in, just bring your ID with you, and we will use that to look up your order in the system and check you in. Update any information that might be off in the system, and we'll get you a tour, too.
Corey's asking, first of all, Corey said the staff does a great job. They're still trying to find their place, but they still come to the club. That's a common thread, especially with newer people, is feeling a little off put or not quite in yet, you know. But I know that happens quickly. I know that people feel comfortable very quickly.
Yes.
But it's going to take a few times. People have to get to know you. They want to see you. Your first time in, it's really tough because I don't want to say people are standoffish, but they just... they kind of let you do your thing. You know, they're not going to jump on you and pounce on you and, you know, time to party.
If you look like you don't want to be approached, people will read that and respect that.
Correct.
Because our community is all about consent. So if you look like you don't want to be approached, they're going to try to respect and honor that for you and give you your space. So I really find for new people, trying to connect on the news feed is a great way. Sometimes people in the news feed invite people to other activities outside of the club where members get together. Those are great non-pressure situations that if, you know, you decide you want to do, can help build connections.
Right.
You know.
I always say my biggest advice is if you're ever thinking of attending, your first event should always be on a Friday that isn't a Freaky Friday. Those are probably the most comfortable when it comes to like, there's not as many members as there would be on a Saturday, and then you can get comfortable in where you are and what you to expect versus like being in a new place, being surrounded by a bunch of new people versus like a more controlled amount of like new people. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like a Saturday night with 250 people.
Yeah, can be a little intimidating.
Yeah, it can definitely be somewhat overwhelming for some people.
But some of our other events are a lot more intimate in like there's less people, so people don't feel as rushed to move from like one group of people to the next to try to find what they're looking for. They'll sit, they'll talk, they'll engage in longer conversations, and it really helps you get to know people and the lifestyle, and everybody's very open, so questions are usually answered no problem.
Yeah, a good way to go.
Stevie Steer says non-Freaky Fridays are the best for casual chatter and getting comfortable.
So, since we're on the subject of Freaky Fridays,
yes,
I wanted to make the announcement that Only Flesh has confirmed for April 7th. So they are going to be performing Hook Suspension at DVNC on April 7th. I don't know what else. I'm pretty sure they're going to be doing a couple other things. For sure they're going to be doing Hook Suspension. So their website, Zoey, can you look up their website and put that in? Sorry about that. I should have had that ready. We have a little notes thing. I should have chatted. Hey, pull this up, but I got you. Bonnie already knows who they are. Queso knows who they are. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're a staple here. They're originally from Columbus, right. Ohio, but they've pretty much become staples here in Pittsburgh, and they're well known throughout the community. Mm-hmm. Super cool. We met with them. When did we meet with them? In November.
Oh my God. Yeah. It was like November or so.
Yeah. And so we set this up. We were trying to get them for some other dates. We just couldn't get everything meshed. So this was the first date we could get them in. And so, yeah, we're pretty excited.
Yeah. So Valfreya says, I'm going to miss it, but I saw a woman do Hook Suspension from her stomach here in Columbus. Yeah, they're unbelievable. And actually, I've seen somebody that gets suspended from their knees, like within their kneecaps, just a little bit further up. It's like, oh, yeah, pretty intense. But a lot of fun to watch, that's for sure.
So prior to Only Flesh, a good friend of ours from the Groundhog Society used to do the Hook Suspension. And one of the things they did I thought was really cool. I think it was maybe our second year for Easter. They did the Resurrection Hook Suspension. Like literally coming out of, they came out of a coffin, right? Wasn't it like a coffin that they got pulled out of?
Yes, it was.
I mean, it was very cool and elaborate. They had this coffin on the dance floor and somebody laying in it, and they had them all pinned up, and then they just slowly wheeled them up out of the thing.
Yeah. Like
Resurrection. So
yeah, it was pretty intense.
Yeah. I mean, I am not, Queso's not saying they're not into the Hook Suspension. I am not necessarily either. And I'm just going to tell you, if you're thinking about coming to Only Flesh on April 7th.
Yeah.
Really give it a thought and look up Hook Suspension online. There's probably some videos or whatever, and just make sure, because it's really, this is a more intense sort of performance.
Right.
So just, you know, obviously you can leave the room and go to other areas of club also, but if you're coming there specifically to watch Only Flesh, and have not seen them before or not familiar with it, do a little research.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Wow.
That was the announcement. That was all the, well,
I'm going to try to put the link to their site in the chat.
All right. We'll see if we can do this. See if that works. Let me see. Yeah, Bonnie says they do. Band. Sorry. Did that work?
I think so.
I don't think they do the, whatchamacallit, the band stuff anymore.
Yeah, I think they haven't done any gigs since like 2019 pre-COVID.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember them saying, because I remember asking them about the band stuff, and they said that they weren't doing that right now.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm pretty excited about it. So, yeah, we've got Cassidy.com and Illust Rich, the first. Right. And then 6 days later, you got Only Flesh.
Right.
Listen, we're coming out. That is very exciting. Ring action.
Mm-hmm. And then we have Ronnie in June. No, in July.
No. May. No?
In May. May. Oh, my God. Yes.
I'm telling you. Fucking, we're going to kill it. Killing it.
What about Christmas in July?
Oh, Mary Lou. Letting everything out of the bag.
No, I don't know.
Yes, we're doing Christmas in July.
But sure. You know what? Only Flesh has been here before.
Yes, they were. They were here for the Bondage Ball.
For Bondage Ball, yes. And they did perform that event. But that was, oh my God, what, 4 years ago?
2019.
Yeah. Yeah, 4 years ago.
August of 2019 is when we did Bondage Ball. That was the Steel City Eroticon.
Yes.
I remember that.
And were you working here then?
I'm not sure. If I was just like volunteering every once in a while when you needed help.
Veronica was my first year.
I mean, like, I was here. I just, because I've been a member since 2018.
Yeah.
Okay, so are you asking about Bondage Ball or Steel City Eroticon? Well, actually, I can answer that. Bondage Ball, probably not. We don't own that. That's not our event. Mm-hmm. Steel City Eroticon is our event, and there is a high probability that that will come back.
Yeah.
We more than likely not for this year, just because when we do it again, we're going to do it big. So.
Big Bacchus asked if... about an event on the 25th. I assume they're asking of April. I don't think we have gotten all the events out for April.
They're talking about the 25th, Nerdy and Dirty. That should be live. It is not.
I'm Ooh. Looking.
Good catch. It is live.
It's alive.
Yes. So, okay. So, hey, we'll just March 25th. Wow. Fuck me. I totally fucked that. Yes. Dirty and Dirty is the event on March 25th.
Yep.
It is now live.
It's a Comic-Con.
Yeah. In G's defense, he did literally tell me before this live stream to check chicketing, and I decided to do it after the live stream. So,
wow.
In G's defense, I'll take that fall. That's my bad. I apologize.
That event has been up for a couple of weeks and was supposed to be live.
So. Dirty, dirty. Woo.
Yeah.
That used to be called something else. That was Talk Nerdy to Me.
Yes, we've done Talk Nerdy to Me, Nerdy and Dirty.
Mm-hmm. What was the one? Wasn't it like my birthday last year? It was like Flash Bang Bob or like, no, that was a superhero party.
Bang Smash Wow.
Yeah.
Bang Smash Wow. That was last night.
And that is another subject matter.
Last night I was smothered and covered.
Oh.
I was like, what is going on right now?
I ate blueberry muffins.
Yeah, G was smothered and covered.
I was smothered and covered. At least my hash browns were.
Yeah, I saw the pictures of your smothered and covered, and I was jealous. Because I haven't had Waffle House in like forever.
Oh, it was so good. We literally, when we were walking in, the cook pulled into the like parking lot and almost hit me and Sherilyn. And I was like, that's how you know the food's going to be so good. The redder the eye, the better the fry. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What did you say?
I said the redder the eye, the better the fry, if you know what I'm saying.
I don't know what that means.
The redder the eye, the better the fry.
You can keep saying it. I still don't get it.
What gives you red eyes, G? What gives you red eyes?
The first time I ever went to Gabby.
I don't know. What are we talking about?
You get high before you go to work. Anyways, I think the first time I was at a place called Gabby, I think it's in Carnegie, the cook had an eye patch and a shirt on that said, "Don't neglect the balls." And they have like an open kitchen. And I was like, that's the coolest fucking dude I've ever seen in my life.
Don't neglect the balls.
But yeah. Red eyes, like if they're like stoned or getting redder the eye, the better the fry.
Yeah, the food tastes better when you're blasted.
Oh yeah. Well, no, like when the chef's blasted, that's how you know the food's gonna be good.
Yeah.
I don't know that that's right, but
I think it is.
It's true.
Bonnie says, "Smothered and covered doesn't sound sexy. It sounds like a UTI."
Actually, it sounds like a bukkake party to me.
I would agree with that.
Let's do a smothered and covered party.
It sounds like a cuddle bukkake party.
Yeah.
Wait, yes. Smothered and covered, it'll be a cuddle party.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
I mean, yeah, I was thinking orgy turtle, but yeah.
Yeah.
Or, you know, unless they have like a king for like suffocation with pillows. Smothered and covered would be the perfect title for that one.
Well, G's never actually been to
Waffle House. I like how Bonnie goes from bukkake to no to cuddle okay.
Yeah, I've never been to Waffle House either. We're going to have to make that a field trip one day.
It's delicious. It's so delicious.
Oh, so Valfrey is saying wrestling in oil or chocolate or something. We do Jello wrestling in the fall.
We do.
So you'll have to stick around for that one, Valfrey.
When are we going to do Jello? Are we going to do that in July or August? Or when are we doing it? I think we should do it in like July or August.
Earlier?
I think we can discuss that. We'll put it on the manager's meeting.
Yeah, I guess we don't have to discuss it now. Yeah. Let's have our meeting now. Yeah. Maybe we should do that. Maybe we should have our manager meetings live.
Oh, my God. No. God.
They don't want to sit with us for 2.5 hours.
You never know.
The behind the scenes.
No, we use the weird water pellets.
Or beans.
Orbeez.
Speaking of Orbeez, someone in my hometown got arrested. So this is from where I'm from. There's so much of nothing to do that two girls were arrested for shooting people with an Orbeez gun in their car while they drove by.
How do you?
They're water pellets. That?
I mean, what?
How do you do that? Like, what? I don't understand.
Like, there's like Nerf guns, but instead of like Nerf darts, it's like Orbeez. And people were like doing like drive-by shootings with these Orbee guns. And they got arrested for assault.
Now, I've heard of people putting Orbeez in like town fountains as a prank. And then, you know, there's like little balls everywhere. You know? But yeah. I don't know.
There's those people that they're like basement flooded, so they just poured a bunch of Orbeez on it.
Yeah.
That's convenient. That's a little hack if you don't have a shop vac. Just pour a bunch of Orbeez on it.
Well, what was the other thing with the Orbeez? Oh my God. Oh, like when we clean out the Jello ring of the Orbeez, sometimes they don't all fall in the dumpster. So you'll see like these little shriveled up little pink or blue colored little nuggets on the ground. And as soon as it rains, all of a sudden it's like,
they blow back up.
They blow back up. And I'm like, we're still trying to get rid of these things from like September. They're still around come November, December.
I guess technically we could save them, just dry them all out and reuse them.
Yeah.
You just put them in the sun. You know.
What do you think, Anne? Should we do that?
I don't know.
I think it'd be fun if we did something along the lines of like, if we did the Jello Wrestling, if we ever moved the Jello Wrestling to the back parking lot for some godforsaken reason, if we did a slip and slide into the wrestling ring.
It's not a terrible idea.
It's not a terrible idea.
It'd be pretty fun. It'd be pretty fun.
You got to find a slide.
I mean, we got tarp and baby oil. We're chilling, right?
Not when they hit that asphalt. There. Oh my god.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, Queso.
Yep. Oh, cool.
Bonnie's asking, do we get giant ones, like a giant slip and slide?
No, as in the giant sized Orbeez. We get the normal sized ones. We don't go big.
Right. But I like the idea of reusing them.
Yeah.
Jason says, is there such thing as chocolate pudding wrestling? But I say that would mess with every single AFAB person's pH balance.
Thank you.
Yeah, we can't. You don't actually want to wrestle in food stuff like that because it's not good when it gets inside of you. It's going to cause a problem somehow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
While I do enjoy cranberry juice, I don't need to drink it for 2 weeks straight. Yeah.
Every time. Okay. Every time I hear somebody mention cranberry juice, I think of the movie The Departed with Leonardo DiCaprio. And there's a scene where he's sitting at a bar and he's sitting at the bar drinking a cranberry juice. And this guy comes up to him and he sits down next to him. He says, what are you drinking there? And Leonardo DiCaprio responds, I'm drinking cranberry juice. And the guy responds, what are you on your fucking period? And Leonardo DiCaprio proceeds to beat the crap out of the guy. So, my point to saying that is every time I hear cranberry juice, I think of that scene in that movie and I want to say, what are you on your period?
Mm-hmm. I see someone, the Blackheart straight game, yes. Exactly what you were talking about.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
Oh my God.
But yeah, you've got to watch the movie. He's undercover.
At that point. Okay. Right. Cool.
So,
it would be more of an accurate question if he asked if he had a urinary tract infection and not his period.
Yeah. Periods and cranberry juice don't really do anything.
I don't think being technically medically correct in that was the intent of the scene. But the intent of the scene was to be an asshole to Leonardo DiCaprio. Like,
okay.
Sounds like that goal was achieved.
Yeah, it does.
It was.
But still, you know, Queso points out that, you know, he was indicating that he was a woman because he was not drinking alcohol. And it's like, whoa, that could be offensive as well, you know? So.
Yeah, I mean, definitely a lot of machismo. I mean, that's the whole point. It's a gangster movie. So, I mean, There's inherently built-in machismo into that.
You know. They're busting balls.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is, you know? So.
More the way it was.
Yes. So.
Oh, I didn't know Alexander was married to Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah. Nor does he, but hey, I mean.
Nor does he. my God.
I love how everyone's avoiding Big Bacchus's comment.
I'm not avoiding anything. I'm just sitting here talking.
They're not saying anything.
G, do you want to share the story now?
I'm just saying it's bad.
We got 14 people in here, all strapped and ready to go with nothing
there's,
but
no,
time.
No, technically there's 19 people, oh, 20 got, including me.
We got nothing but time. Mm. Nothing but time. Mm.
Here, I'll even chime you in for it. Oh, I can't.
That was mildly anticlimactic.
Yes. I totally get it, Queso. Totally get it.
Scene. Go.
Yes, Queso, I agree. Michael saying poo. All right, so let's just say hashtag clean out stories. It's it's no secret that now all of a sudden we don't want to hear it. Oh, we can stop.
I'm chilling.
Go ahead. I mean, Anne's just kind of like
I'm not phased. I don't know.
Anyway. Last night, hashtag clean out stories, I'm doing my thing, and lo and behold, something comes out. And I'm like, oh, well, that's interesting. And it was interesting because it was in a very specific shape. And that shape reminded me of two things. The first was a very large comma. And I know Sherilyn likes Oxford commas, so that's why I said comma. And then a sperm. But a really big one. And I stood there looking at it like, wow, this would be an interesting story on the live stream. So...
Marilu's crying. Marilu's crying.
I could go in so many directions with that, but I just right now I'm just like,
why don't we just sit and let it be for like,
yeah,
just process it real fast.
What do we have going on next weekend?
Ding! And that was G's story.
I was yes. trying to look up.
It was a large brown sperm, though, turtle.
So when I was a kid, my sister received a poster that was called The Shit List. And it had all the different types of poop on it. And I was trying to get you a description of which one it is.
You know what? If I were smart, I should have taken a picture of it.
No.
No. Yeah, it was like a big comma. I'm going to try and draw a picture of it. I'm going to, you know what? I'm not a really good artist. Do we know it? Can anybody do like, photo sketch? Yes. Let's do a photo sketch.
Okay. Oh my God.
All right. So it was bulbous on one end.
Bulbous on one end. I'm sorry.
Bulbous on one end, like the bulbous end of a comma. And then just like a comma, like it came out like, okay, so you know like like when they make the hurricane thing on TV, on the Weather Channel, it's got the two tails?
Yeah.
Well, imagine this is one tail.
How like thick is it in comparison?
And Brad's in the house.
Well, enough that it reminded me of a sperm also, but like maybe like a kind of mildly deformed sperm, like probably one that wasn't going to make it.
Okay. And it only had one tail?
Big Bacchus wants to know if a visual aid is necessary.
I guess so, because, I mean...
No, it wasn't long at all. No, it wasn't. No, that's what I'm saying. It looked like a fucking comma. It was not long at all. It wasn't like a long turd with a long tail. It was a little bloop.
So we're talking like...
Oh my God.
Yes, thank you, Bonnie. I agree. That wasn't the intent of the clean out, but you know what? Okay, so
I drew it longer.
Oh wait, yeah, forget that part. Okay, but that little bulbous, like where your finger is, kinda cut that off. Like there's a little bulb there. in the tail. Like, just straighten that out. Mutant sperm, yeah. No. Yeah, we're going to get this right. We're going to have a visual aid for you. No, I don't even know what that is now. That looks like somebody got their leg broken.
Listen, we're trying.
That's super sperm. That's totally different.
Okay.
Left at Jello Wrestling came back to poo. Yeah. Sorry, Alfreya.
Yeah. Stephanie, you're right. I probably should have.
Yeah. Is this good?
No. No, you had it close. You know what? Hold on. I got this. I think I'm going
to
be able to.
And then we're going to go into what's upcoming this weekend.
Yeah, why don't you talk about this?
I haven't had enough of poo.
I'm drawing my sperm poo from last night.
Oh, my
okay.
God.
Okay, so this upcoming Friday is a new event for us. It's called Social Lubricant. And, we understand coming to the club, it can be intimidating or scary to some people. Especially when you are questioning or just, at the beginning of discovering, your sexuality or where you fit into this. And we're making this event to be kind of like a mix and mingle. You can still play. But we're going to have our host, Sherilyn, is going to be out there helping you guys mix and mingle, doing a couple activities with you throughout the event. Mm-hmm. That way everybody can chat, get to know each other, make new friends, and maybe some connections.
Yay!
And then Saturday, St. Patty's Day event. So that one more than likely will sell out. So get your tickets ahead of time. We are going to have a... the best kilt and buns contest. So make sure that you bring, something that shows off your booty and your skills to go with it.
Awesome.
Bonnie's asking about games in the lobby.
In the lounge, yeah.
Yeah, in the lounge. Yeah.
We're going to have some stuff going on, absolutely.
We had to think for a second. Lobby, lounge, a little different.
Yeah, the lobby is the room you check in at, and then the lounge is the one with the food. So in the lounge area.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
so.
Oh, my God.
St. Patty's Spit Roasting Party. All right, so do you want to see the photo now? My photo.
Oh my God.
Go for it.
The likeness. This is just a likeness. This isn't exactly what it looked like, but
I see. A message emoticon.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, it was more like that.
Or a pear.
Like, but imagine it's laying on the ground.
Half a yin yang symbol.
Is it just not like a comma?
Well, I mean, it could be a spin.
Oh, I like how you described it as one you think is not going to make it.
That one seemed hardy. He seemed fine.
Jason is asking what our wildest party is. And I think that really depends on what your definition of where wild exists for you. Our sold-out event every year is Halloween. All the glow parties are amazingly attended. Member appreciation, halfway to Halloween, Jello Wrestling, Mardi Gras. There's just so many.
I know.
Yeah. I think it's New Year's. I mean,
Jason, it's a plethora of wild times here at the club.
Yeah.
No matter which one you prefer.
Don't lie, it's the sock hop.
Sherilyn is a very big fan of the sock hop, like 50s style.
Which
was a great event, too.
One of my favorite ones is the cock hop.
My favorite event is probably halfway to Halloween because I can dress really slutty like I do on Halloween, but I don't have to be cold.
There you go.
That's a good point. That's actually
iconic.
All right, so we're going to talk about.
Ryan's turtle's like, and now another major event, arts and crafts at the body shop.
DJ Rock and Ronnie is confirmed for halfway to Halloween. I just confirmed that this week also.
Yay.
Tomstrips.com is the sponsor of the event again. The reason they're sponsoring this event and the reason we're working with Tom's Trips is because we're going to Hedonism in October 7th through the 14th.
Yes.
Which is the first ever complete takeover of Hedonism for bye week.
Yes.
So we are going to be there for that. So we are pushing that because we're going to be there. My first time going there ever.
Yes. He's a hedo virgin.
Dun, dun, dun. Mm. I was told by somebody that their intent is to, because I definitely won't be working, to connect.
Ooh. Setting up dates already. Nice. Get those connections.
This early in the game?
Absolutely. Get those connections.
It seems by the time I get there, I might have every evening filled.
Good for you. Yeah.
Mary's like, see ya. Mary's like, I'm filling my dating card too.
Okay.
What else? Halfway to Halloween. Mary Lou brought up halfway or Christmas in July. We're doing that. We've got that on the schedule. We talked briefly about Nude Year's Eve, a halfway to New Year's Eve. And I only mentioned that because Zoey mentioned about the being able to dress a little more provocative and not be cold in the summertime for halfway to Halloween.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So we could do a Nude Year's Eve and it would be like a homage to being a nudist.
There you go.
Or hedo.
Or hedo, yes. Mm-hmm. So Jason, we will be attending all of the Exoticas this year.
Yes.
So not just Jersey, but Chicago in April and everything in between.
Brad says that if Mary Lou is filling her schedule, that he'll be attending Hedo as well.
I'll, see just what happens there. You. Huh, Brad?
That's bye week, right? So yeah. You have to be bye to be able to go.
No, you do, Brad, not. Brad,
the night is still young.
Oh.
Ba-dum-bum. I think that does that deserve a maraca or does that deserve a
there you go. Mary Lou's gonna be the sound effects person.
That's just because I've got all the stuff in my office.
Turtle, everything is penciled in. Everything in my life is penciled in, by the way. Because it can change in a moment. So
some bongos?
Alexandra says bongos.
I don't have bongos in here. I have a violin in the other room.
We got to get you to play your violin on live stream.
I'm playing the world's smallest violin.
Yeah.
Anyway. Bonnie says I want to know more about halfway to Halloween.
Halfway to Halloween sparks the fun ability to be sexy because it's actually above 60 degrees in Pittsburgh when we're having a Halloween party where you can dress like a whore and get away with it, as Regina George would say.
Yes. As a whore.
I love dressing like a whore. So any excuse to dress like a whore and not be cold, sign me in.
What is the male presenting equivalent to dressing like a whore?
Dressing with the slutty male waist.
What does that mean?
Slutty male waste.
Don't guys have slutty male waste?
I want the freaking bra top again.
Guys can be slutty.
Well, yes, we can be slutty, but slutty in...
Like, dressing-wise?
Attire. What are examples what I'm saying, like attire, like what?
Let's think, like, crop tops, the 80s hair metal, they were all so slutty. All the guys in, like, 80s hair metal bands were slutty as hell.
Are you saying... Hold on.
So, wait a minute, wouldn't that just be a fuckboy?
No, but what... There is clothing that a female presenting person can wear that catches the male gaze, right?
Mm-hmm.
Signals, I'm ready to have some fun. Signals. I'm not saying it's a consent. I'm saying it's signaling. What is the male presenting equivalent to that?
What do you like?
I don't think, because I don't know. There's nothing that I think I could wear as a female that says I'm looking to get down unless it's like lingerie. So,
yeah.
So maybe some boxers or tighty whities, a nice robe, some
a cheek string,
rip away pants.
I love, Alexandra's hoes do not get cold. We thrive off how sexy and fierce that I dress up. Then that makes me feel amazing.
Hoes don't get cold, but this hoe has low iron.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Brad suggests that gray sweatpants and a big one to fill them would be slutty attire for... What?
Stringer tanks are also in the same.
Yeah, I agree with Stephanie. Confidence is sexy.
Confidence. Yeah. Also think of just like the 80s, how like guys would wear like 3-inch inseam shorts all the time. That was a little funny.
And, like mesh shirts that were completely see-through.
Yeah. They'd have like the 3-inch inseam and then like the 2 inches of abdomen and then their shirt.
They're crop tops. Yeah.
Oh, you're describing. Okay, got it. That was the question. Like what is, you know, what can I put on? You know, is it a suit? Is it a, you know, like what is it?
Or you know, like I said, 80s hair metal bands, they had like the deep V like unbuttoned. They had like one at their belly button. That was it.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget your Z Cavaricis.
Yeah. Leather pants.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Is universally.
Yep. You know, I've never worn leather pants in my entire life.
I've worn leather pants. They tend to rip in the ass.
Yeah.
Quite a bit, because you get, like, no friction.
That's generally the first place to go.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
I've had quite a few leather pants rip in the ass while I'm here, and I'm like, well, it's a good thing I'm at this job. Like,
okay, so Michael says that they had a gorgeous mullet back in the 80s. Like some serious Duran Duran looking hair. Was it really Duran Duran or was it more like Flock of Seagulls?
Hmm. Speaking of mullets, I wore my hair down tonight. I was talking to a friend last weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And they were commenting that when they were watching the live stream, that looked like I had a halo around my head. Like this was all glowing. Because my hair was all pulled back. So I thought I'd wear it down tonight to see if there was a different effect. So.
Oh, that was just your Jesus super star halo going on.
I think it actually was just, you know, because my hair was pulled back and the hair light over me was really shining on it. Maybe it was too bright, but it did look weird when I was watching it.
Well, yes.
Unbridled sexy experimentation is so sexy.
Yeah.
Hmm. Fishnet tights and a cute black dress. Yeah. I mean, we haven't, you know, we haven't done in a long, long, long time.
What?
A little black dress night.
Just a little black dress?
Mm-hmm.
Little kinky dress?
We've done little kinky dress. Little
kinky dress. We should probably redo that.
You know.
We talked about doing that again.
Mm-hmm. We also haven't done our pin-up night in a while.
Yeah.
That's a good night, too.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Or bridled if you're in a pony play. I think Mary Lou would do that.
What, pony play?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I totally. I mean, I have a bridle. It's in the box. Yeah, it's in the toy chest.
My favorite is the like House of Taboo videos where like there's just like a cage that's like 1 foot in diameter in the ground that like he covers. Have you ever seen those videos?
What is
like? I think it's called like House of Taboo or something like that. But they're like this BDSM porn company, and like some of their stuff is like they have it's like a tiny hole in the wall, like probably the size of this notebook, like not in the wall, in the floor. And he'll put like one of his subs in a cage, put her in the thing, and then just cover it up with like one of those fake carpet spots so it completely blends in. I'm like, that is terrifying to me, at least.
And what is it called again?
I think it's called House of Taboo.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to look at that. What's up, Mer Sausage?
Hey, Mer Sausage.
Just made it in the nick of time.
Mm-hmm. Hello. And on that note, did we talk about this weekend's events?
Oh, yeah. We got to buzz through that. We're already an hour.
We did talk about this weekend's events.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Patrick's Day. Yeah.
We did.
Yay.
Okay. This is bad of me, but I'm really looking forward to Saturday. Because I just want to eat corned beef.
Oh, yeah. Corned beef. I'm so excited. Corned beef. We like meat here.
We like food.
Let's just clarify. We like food.
Yeah. This weekend, we got the meat.
I need to find Kimmelwick rolls down here. I don't know if that's a Buffalo thing.
What is it?
I heard it's. Do you guys have beef on wicks down here?
Have what?
It's a Buffalo thing. It's a Buffalo thing. Beef on wick. It's like roast beef or like corned beef on a Kimmelwick roll, which is like large grain salt and like poppy seeds. It's really tasty.
I mean, listen, I'm down to try anything corned beef and bread. Sure.
Beef on wick. That's so good.
Oh. Okay. Merely so yeah, it's top round roast beef, horseradish sauce, beef broth. You know, it's kind of like a French dip, but with the cheese and everything. And
it's good. Yeah. It's like a Buffalo thing. I don't know. Loganberry is also a really good Buffalo thing. It's like this soda that's raspberry and blackberry flavored.
So tasty. Now you're killing me.
Any Buffalo homies? How you doing?
Speaking of that, where I didn't see the other Zoey.
Right. Other Zoey would know what I'm talking about.
We got ditched.
It looks like a roast beef sandwich.
It's so tasty.
It does.
Listen, I'm down. Let's do it.
But it's like a roast beef and French dip.
It's like a weird mix. It's so good. You get
like the au jus sauce or whatever.
Hey, Elizabeth.
Hey, Elizabeth.
I hope your night gets better. Tomorrow's a new day.
I'm a chip girl.
Hell of a good chip dip is my go-to. But Lawson's chip dip, for those of you who are from Ohio.
Another Buffalo thing, blue bison chip dip.
I bet you it's the same chip dip.
Similar to hell of a good chip dip.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So is Lawson's.
Yeah. So remember when we went to Hawaii and there was an actual deli that was called Lawson's? And like I ran in there going like, oh my God, do they have Lawson's dip? And it's like, yeah, no.
No, different Lawson's. I don't even think Lawson's is around anymore. What's that?
What is chip dip?
It's like French onion dip.
Yeah.
Oh. It's like.
Oh, you just mean like, okay.
Yeah.
I was like, is that some weird other concoction? I don't know.
Well, yeah, in Ohio, it was just called Lawson's dip because that was the
brand.
The brand.
Yeah, Lawson's. Lawson's.
Yeah, and that was like the chain. It was like instead of 7-Elevens, there was Lawson stores everywhere. So, yeah.
It was just a random niche company that was specifically chip dip called Blue Bison Dip.
Pretty much.
Uh-huh.
Same with, that's pretty much what Lawson's is.
So good.
Was.
I'm going to be buying some.
Okay, now y'all are making me hungry.
Yeah.
No, I'm like, I need to.
Yeah, we're all hungry. Oh, speaking of hungry, go ahead, Marilu.
No, I wanted to shout out to Zoey here because they got me a sugar cookie today, and it was like a traditional sugar cookie that I'm used to from Puerto Rico, like with all the jimmies and stuff on it. Mm-hmm. It was perfect. It hit the spot. Okay. Thank good you loving. So much.
Yeah.
And now I have jimmies all over my desk and my keyboard.
Yeah, it's the Good Lovin' Cookie Shop. It's like literally right across the bridge.
I have an oatmeal raisin cookie for after this live show. So I'm very excited.
I have a waffle and chicken wrap for after this live show.
Yeah, I didn't
I said, we like food.
I gorged it.
There's a lot of conversation about food every day.
Every day. Oh my God. But anywho, this weekend we'll have corned beef. Yay! Woo!
Just really quick, speaking of sweets, Marilu and I killed 2 bags of the popcorn that our friend Bonnie brought. So thank you for the popcorn. We're down to, I think we have 1 or 2 bags left now.
I'm only admitting this because we're on live stream and it's going to be less of a reaction, but I did eat all of the Cinnamon Toast Crunch popcorn today.
What do you think less of a reaction means? Like, you're not going to get murdered after the live stream?
Yeah. I have witnesses now.
Well, wait a minute. G had the Choco or the Cocoa Puff ones or something?
Yeah, I didn't get to try any of the Cocoa Puff ones.
Yeah.
Hashtag me too, Ann.
And what else? Oh, I had the Snickers and the Butterfinger ones. Oh, and I also had the caramel and cheese. Though I fished out all the caramel and left all the cheese for G.
Which was perfect.
That's just the way we do. But yeah.
I had some of the Twix one. It was really good.
I had the rest of it.
The Cinnamon Toast Crunch one was so tasty.
Zoey. It's a good thing you're faster than me.
Well, this weekend it's corned beef and pretzels.
Nice.
Yes, yeah. Bring your pretzel.
I don't know if you guys noticed there's a theme here. Marilu keeps going right back to the corned beef. I think this is number 7 that she's mentioned that there's going to be corned beef this weekend.
Maybe we can cook one tomorrow.
Oh.
Mm. With some butter. And butter. We can make a butter.
I don't know what else to say.
Can we make a butter board tomorrow?
Well, just for us?
Yeah, just for us.
We can.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I even have the edible flowers.
Only.
Okay. Well, I feel like we've kind of like taken over the cast right now with food. And people are saying goodbye.
Bye, Alexander. Yeah, we should probably get out of here.
They have things to do. They don't want to hear about our food.
Yeah.
Unless we're inviting them.
No, they do want to hear about our food because, you know, then they know what we like and they can send gifts.
Marilu's going right to the semi-shit appeal.
Well, you know, they're not on my Amazon list. But if anyone wants my Amazon list, I can put it up on the feed. But
no, Marilu has an Instacart list.
Yeah.
I need to make an Amazon list.
Oh my God.
All right. I'm going to wrap up the show by suggesting that if you've made it through this live stream, especially this live stream, and you still want to attend, then please visit my wife's site, MarilyLewandYou.com. And book at least 3 appointments because you're going to need them.
Wait a minute. Were you starting to say MarilyLewandFood.com?
Yeah, MarilyLewandPoo.com. Yes, don't go to there. Don't go to MarilyLewandPoo. That's probably a really nefarious site.
A really despicable site.
Yes, very despicable. Do not visit MarilyLewandPoo.com. Do visit MarilyLewandYou.com.
There you go.
Which is right here on the thing below me somewhere.
Yes, Brad, crab legs are on it.
Yes, crab legs. Holy shit. We got to get out of here.
Okay. Goodbye, everyone.
No. Visit bodyshopclubs.com. Fill out your application. We have a new cap video. We have cap 2.0. This is a new version. We've updated it to match our new policies. Make sure you watch it. Once you do that, your application can be approved. If you don't watch that video, if you don't do the whole thing, you're going to get declined. So do that. I think that's it. Am I missing anything? Did I forget anything?
No, I don't think so.
All right, cool. Listen, peeps, I appreciate you guys watching. We went a little longer than usual. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We will see you next week. Same time, same bat channel. And that's it. Hey, folks.
Bye. Good night.
Bye. Bye.
I love meat and coffee. Good night, Kaz.